election has put the political future of five leaders in doubt. These five names now face the ultimate test, the test for political relevance. Let's start with Rahul Gandhi. This was his first general election as Congress president, and he failed yet again. Rahul Gandhi has failed to revive the fortunes of Congress. In fact, in a major setback, he could not even retain his bastion of Amethi. After yesterday's defeat, a few things have become clear. His slogan, Chaukidar Chor Hai, failed to click. There were only a few takers for the Nyay pitch. Perhaps Rahul Gandhi's biggest failure was his inability to stitch critical alliances in states like Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal and Delhi. It now seems like the Congress will have to pay a hefty price for this defeat. Congress governments in Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan are hanging by a thread. Next, we have Priyanka Gandhi Vadra. She was the wild card or the Brahmastra. Clearly, her political debut did not make any difference. Priyanka Gandhi Vadra was appointed in charge of Uttar Pradesh East, just like her brother. She launched an aggressive campaign against Prime Minister Modi. There was an intense speculation that she might take on Narendra Modi in Varanasi. She herself fueled it, yet stepped back at the last moment. She campaigned for her brother in Amethi after Rahul Gandhi's defeat. It's clear that Priyanka Gandhi Vadra failed to leave a mark. Priyanka was quite candid about her strategy. She had said that her candidates in East UP will either fight to win or cut into BJP's votes. Now it seems they took away votes from the Gathbandhan. Her brother has suffered another defeat. There is a serious question mark over Rahul Gandhi's leadership abilities now. It will be interesting to see what role Priyanka plays in the Congress. Third on our list is Mayawati. The BSP supremo was pegged to be a prime ministerial candidate. The Grand Alliance was supposed to fuel the resurgence of the BSP. But now Mayawati stares at political oblivion. Her party may be leading in 11 seats, but that's just not enough to make a dent on the national scene. There were high expectations from the UP Grand Alliance, but they have failed spectacularly. It's clear now that the Grand Alliance strategy may have worked in last year's bipoll, but it cannot be a long-term solution. This result is also an indicator that caste-based politics has lost its relevance. The other partner in this alliance was Akhilesh Yadav. His party, the SPA, has fared worse. They are leading on just 6 seats. His defeat in UP state election of 2017 came as a shock. Akhilesh Yadav has been trying to make a comeback ever since. He placed a bet this time on Mayawati. According to several reports, his father, Mulayam Singh Yadav, wasn't happy about the Grand Alliance, but he still went ahead. It's clear now that caste arithmetic won't be enough to dethrone the BJP in Uttar Pradesh. The future of the Grand Alliance is under question now, and with this result, the comeback of SP and BSP alliance now even is more uncertain. And finally, we have Chandrababu Naidu. His party, the TDP, has been decimated in Andhra Pradesh and wiped out from the national stage. Remember, Andhra Pradesh voted for the assembly as well as the lower house together. Chandrababu Naidu's party has been reduced to double digits in his own state. He has been dethroned by Jagan Reddy. If that wasn't enough, the YSR Congress party is set to sweep the Lok Sabha polls too. They are leading on 24 out of 25 seats. Now, Chandrababu Naidu was part of the NDA, but he walked out last year. He failed to get Andhra Pradesh the special category status. He placed his bets on the opposition. He backed Rahul Gandhi in the last few days. Chandrababu Naidu met with all major opposition leaders. Naidu was trying to stitch a grand opposition alliance. Now, even if opposition parties unite, Chandrababu Naidu is unlikely to have any major role in such an alliance.